Hello everybody, I am Vijay Krishna, working as assistant professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronics at Chebro Engineering College. Today, the subject on power electronics, the topic is about silicon controlled rectifier, SCR. We discuss here about SCR, the characteristics, and here the contents are introduction, silicon controlled rectifier, SCR symbol and schematic diagram, and constructional features of the SCR, cross section of the SCR, and physical operation and its characteristics, and also thyristors and characteristics. Introduction. Thyristors are a family of power semiconductor devices. They are used extensively in power electronic circuits. They are operated as a bistable switches, that is two-way switch, operating from non-conducting state to conducting state. The thyristors can be assumed as ideal switches for many applications, but in practical, they are exhibit some characteristics and also some limitations also. What are the limits we will discuss? And the conventional thyristors are designed without gate control turn-off capability, in which case the thyristor can recover from its conducting state to non-conducting state when the current is brought to zero. That is, here if any switch is to act as a turn on switch, to turn on the switch, or that it should be brings to on state, the gate is to be must and should be provided with a signal. That is a gate control. Here the conventional thyristors are designed without gate control turn-off capability, in which case the thyristors can recover from its conducting state to non-conducting state. But if there is a problem, while we are turning on the any devices, that is SCRs or triacs or diacs, whatever it may be, here the gate is to be must and should be give the signals. Here, next, gate turn-off thyristors are designed to have both control turn-on and turn-off capability. The SCR is the most important special semiconductor device. This device is popular for its forward conducting and reverse blocking characteristics. It's a major one having application. SCR is the most important special semiconductor device. This device is popular for its forward conducting and reverse blocking characteristics. SCRs can be used in high power devices. Examples in the central processing unit of the computer, the SCR used in switch mode, power supplies, and these are some of the examples. Here, compared to transistors, thyristors have lower on state conduction losses, as same as that of the MOSFETs, which is having a low on state conduction losses. Here also for the SCRs, the thyristors or the SCRs have lower on-state conduction losses and also having that high power handling capabilities. High power handling, that is nothing but the high power devices. High power handling capabilities. Here, on another side, if you consider, transistors generally have superior switching performance in terms of faster switching speed and lower switching losses. There are advances are continuously made to achieve devices with the best of both, that is low on state and also switching losses, and also with respect to increasing the power handling capabilities. Each, if you consider, the BJT is having some advantage and the MOSFET is having some advantage, and by comparing these two both, that is the BJT bipolar junction transistors and also the metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistors, we have designed that IGBTs. What about the limitations and also disadvantages which we consider on these two, taking an advantage and manufacturing a new one, that is an IGBT, by comparing both two. Here, with respect to the IGBT, same here also with the SCR is having that MOSFET and SCR, IGBT, the SCR is having that low on-state conduction losses. While conducting, the losses are must and should be. Why? Because the efficiency should be increased, having highest values. Then only there is a possibility to improve the power system capabilities. That is nothing but power system quality can be improved. And also, if you go through the exhaust, SCRs, increasing their power handling capabilities also, which is important. P is nothing but the silicon controlled rectifier. The silicon controlled rectifier or semiconductor controlled rectifier is a two-state. It is also called the bistable, used for efficient power control. An SCR is a parent member of thyristor family. These are all comes under the thyristor family. These are all comes under the thyristor family and is used as a high power electronic. That is the power handling capacity should be, capability should be increases. It's a constructional features, physical operation characters are explained in the following next two sessions. If you observe here, the images of these SCRs with the different ratings. This is nothing but the SCR, anode, and also this is the cathode. If you consider, it is nothing but the gate signals, which we employed here, it is to be gate signals here. Same, the ratings, different ratings for the SCRs are shown here on the image, having the different ratings. Nothing but the current capacity and also the voltage value, that it will be changes. Therefore, the total power handling capabilities are changes. That it should be depend upon the rating of the thyristors or the SCRs. Here, this is nothing but the symbol, thyristor symbol, and also the schematic diagram. Here, a thyristor is a four-layer semiconductor device of a PN-PN structure. PN-PN structure with three PN junctions. We are having that, if you observe here on the schematic diagram here, it is nothing but a symbol, and this is a schematic diagram and image of this SCR. Here, this is nothing but the PN-PN device. Four layer, these are nothing but the four layers. The four layers having that three junctions. This is nothing but first junction, junction one, junction two, and also this is nothing but the junction three. That is a four layer, three junction device. It is a PN-PN device. Here, it has a three terminals, that is anode, cathode, and also the gate. These are all having that, the SCR or the thyristor having that anode, cathode, and also the gate symbols which are shown, that is attached to the terminals, three terminals. Here, the symbol is also shown here with the anode, cathode, and also the gate signal. And this is nothing but the one of the image of the SCR of a 500 volts or 12 amperes rating. The voltage value should be very high, and the rating of the current is to be 12 amperes. And this is nothing but the schematic symbol and schematic diagrams. Next, constructional features. How about the constructional features of an SCR or the thyristor has been? That is, the SCR is a four-layer structure, either PN-PN or NPN, that effectively blocks current through two terminals and until it is turned on by a small signal at a third terminal. That is, what about this point? It is a four-layer device. Whenever anode is given with the supply with respect to cathode of low potential, positive, high potential, and low potential, if the voltage is applied here, if the voltage is applied here, that it not turn on while applying the voltage. After that it is not turned on without any gate signal. That is, if you given any gate signal, if you not given any gate signal up to that point, that is only in off state only. Whenever gate signal is given, then only the carriers are moving from the anode to potential towards the cathode potential, that it acting as a switch. Here, that is nothing point. Here, effectively blocks current through two terminals until it is turned on by a small signal at a third terminal. The third terminal is nothing but the gate. The SCR has two states actually. That is high current, low impedance on state, and a low current, high impedance off state. Actually, the basic transistor action in four-layer PN-PN structure is analyzed in the next session of next slides. That is having that first with only two terminals and third control input is introduced here. Here, the thyristors are manufactured by diffusion manner. The cross section of the thyristors has been shown here. This is nothing but the cross section of the thyristors here, which can be split into two sections of NPN and also the PNPN. This is nothing but the NPN, and also this is nothing but the PNPN. This is completely a cross section of the PNPN structure. Here, If suppose, come to the slide, cross section of the thyristors, here, this is nothing but the metal oxide layer. This is the orange symbol which you shown here is a metal oxide layer. And this is nothing but the oxide layer here also. And here, this is also same. Whenever it's splitted, the cross section of this particular complete PNPN structure is splitted into two types, or two sections. That is nothing but split section of NPN and also the PNP. Here, anode is given that here, and next one, cathode is given here, and gate is also here. If you consider how about the device works means, here, when anode voltage is made positive with respect to the cathode, when anode voltage is made more positive with respect to the cathode, the junction J1, J3, this is nothing but the junction J1, J2, J3 here. J1, J3 are forward biased here. If you consider here, J1 and also the J3 junctions are forward biased. The junction J2, how about the junction J2? The junction J2 is reverse biased. Due to these type of connections, that is anode is more made positive with respect to the cathode, when J2 is reverse biased, a small amount of leakage current flows from anode to cathode. A small amount of leakage current flows through anode to cathode here. And here, this thyristor is said to be in a forward blocking state. It is a forward blocking state. That is, we are only giving that supply towards the anode and also the cathode. We doesn't touch any third terminal of a gate terminal. That is, this in this condition, under forward biased condition, anode is made positive with respect to cathode. This is a forward blocking state, or it is also called as off state condition. And a small amount of leakage current flows from anode to cathode in the device is to be, that is nothing but the off state leakage current, denoted with an I suffix D, leakage current. This anode to cathode voltage is increased to sufficiently. If suppose anode to cathode voltage is to be applied for suppose 10 volts. If it is increased to 20 volts, that is anode to cathode voltage is increased to a sufficiently value, that is a large value. A sufficient large value means the amount of the voltage that it should be sufficient to turn on the device. Here, if the anode to cathode voltage is to be increased to a sufficient large value, the reverse biased junction J2 breaks. Here, what about the junction J2 has been placed here is to be occurring the condition of reverse biased condition, that it should be comes into breaks, that is nothing but a breaks. The junction is to be breaks. Whenever the junction breaks, that is called as an avalanche breakdown. Whenever the junction J2 has been breaks, that is called as a avalanche breakdown, and the corresponding junction voltage is called as the forward breakdown voltage, and the voltage is to be called as a forward breakdown voltage. This voltage is nothing but actually when anode is more positive, made positive with respect to cathode with sufficiently large value, that is whenever the junction J2 breaks here, junction J2 breaks, that is called as a avalanche breakdown and is also called as a forward breakdown voltage. Here, under this condition, the junctions J1 and J3 are already in a forward biased condition. Therefore, there is a free movement of carriers from junction J1 to J2 to J3. That is, the free movement of carriers across all the three junctions resulting in a larger forward anode current. Under this condition, a large forward anode current will be moved. Therefore, the device is to be under this condition is called conducting state condition or on state condition. That is nothing but the on state condition. Here, under forward biased condition of anode is made positive with respect to cathode, whenever a small voltage is applied, junction J2 breaks, But what happens whenever the sufficient voltage is to be applied across the anode to cathode, therefore what should be happen? Here, a junction J2 comes to breaks. With respect to this breaking condition, what should be happen means a large anode current will be flow from anode to cathode. That is comes called as a avalanche breakdown or forward breaking voltage. This is nothing but a split section of the NPN transistor. That is nothing but a thyristor is a two transistor analogy. It should be discussed on the two transistor analogy also. That is a combination combines that NPN transistor and also the PNP transistor. Next, what about the operation of these thyristors? Whenever this is under forward bias condition and also the reverse bias condition, what about the reverse bias condition? Here shows that the IV characteristics of a PNPN device of SCR, that it should be shown that this is the anode to cathode voltage of V applied, and it is nothing but the diode current ID value, thyristor current IT value here, and this is nothing but the VAK anode to cathode voltage, thyristor voltage across the supply. Sorry. Next, here from the origin, if you consider, this is comes under the a small voltage has been applied here. Therefore, the voltage value has been this much, and also small leakage current. This is nothing under forward condition, a small leakage current, and this is to be up to the avalanche breakdown. This is called as a forward blocking condition. Up to this is nothing but for avalanche breakdown. That is a forward breaking voltage. It is also called a peak forward voltage. After it should be conducts. That is due to the large anode current, free movement of the carriers with respect to the anode current. Therefore, the curve rises like this. That is the forward bias condition, the reverse bias condition, which illustrates the conducting state and also the reverse blocking state respectively. With respect to these two states, the IV characteristics of the SCR should be observed. Next, about the thyristor circuit and also the IV characteristics. These are the important characteristics of an SCR. Here, if you observe, the voltage will drop due to the ohmic value. What about the resistance has been of a SCR? That it should be having due to resistance, a small amount of drop should be occurs. That is, a voltage will drop due to the ohmic value in the four layers of an SCR. It is a very small value, that is at the less than 1 volt or less than or equal to 1 volt value. In the on state condition, the anode current is limited by an external impedance or a resistance value. That is nothing but this is the resistance R value. Anode current must be more than the value. The anode current must be more than the value of a latching current. Here we discuss about the SCR of a latching current and also the holding current. What is meant by latching current and what is meant by holding current? Here, the anode current must be more than a value known as latching current to maintain the required amount of carrier flow across the junctions. Across the junctions of J1, J2 and J3, actually that is in J2 is to be in a reverse bias condition, reverse blocking condition. But for enough voltage or sufficient voltage is to be whenever applied, what should be happen means the junction J2 to be getting towards on state, forward condition. That is the free movement of the carriers are moving towards the junctions of three layer, junctions of a four layer device. Here, if it is not so, otherwise what happens? The device reverses in the blocking condition as the anode to cathode voltage is reduced. Whenever this anode to cathode voltage is to be applied, voltage to be reduces, what should happen? It should be comes under the reverse blocking condition. Reverse blocking condition. Here, if you observe, this is nothing but the thyristor forward current I sub XT and negative I reverse current. What should be happen reverse under reverse blocking condition? What should be how much amount of reverse current should be flow here? And this is nothing but the anode cathode voltage applied in between. Anode to cathode voltage applied in between the SCR voltage across the SCR. The curve has been drawn here is to be like this from the origin point. If you consider due to the forward blocking due to the forward condition applied, that is anode is made positive with respect to the cathode, that is negative. Here what should be happen? Thyristor doesn't conduct, but what about the junctions J1, J3 comes under towards the forward biased condition. Here what should be happen? Due to J2 reverse blocking condition, what should be happen? The small amount of leakage current flows. This is nothing but the small amount of leakage current up to this value. This is nothing but the small amount of leakage current. With respect to the small amount of leakage current, this curve should be showing like this. After that, if you increase the voltage, that is anode to cathode voltage is to be increased. Anode to cathode voltage is to be increased up to the forward breakdown value. That is nothing but the forward breakover voltage up to this value. What should happen? Forward, there is an avalanche breakdown occurs whenever the voltage value across the thyristor has been increased and the J2 junction comes onto towards the forward condition and the charge carriers are moving forward. Under this condition, what should be happen? The forward breakover occurs, voltage occurs, and this therefore the current should be rise like this. And here shown here without gate pulse, here when you apply the gate pulse, here actually gate is to be turned on. Therefore, the reverse is turned on under the forward condition. But here, before the avalanche breakdown, the gate pulse is applied whenever the forward condition shows. When the anode is made positive with respect to cathode, and also the gate pulse applied here, what should be happen? Here, the gate signal is applied means the voltage is to be moving like this. Up to this point, the device is to be turned on and the current value is to be like this. Rises, that is another anode current value is to be rising. Here about this point, a dotted line, that is the forward breakdown or avalanche breakdown, and also it is the point of a latching point, and it is nothing but the holding current, latching current, and also the holding current. Here the latching current, it is the minimum anode current. The latching current is nothing but the minimum anode current. Here explained here, the latching current is the minimum anode current to maintain the thyristor in the on state immediately after a thyristor has been turned on and the gate signal has been removed. After the thyristor turned on and acting as a light switch, it acts as a switch. The gate signal applied before that has been pulse has been up, signal has been applied, or pulse has been applied. After that, whenever the switch on, there is no requirement of a gate signal. Therefore, the gate signal is removed. Here, this is nothing but the latching current. It is the minimum current required, minimum anode current required to turn on or to maintain the thyristor on state immediately after a thyristor has been turned on. This is nothing but the thyristor has been turned on. That is nothing but the latching current. Here, what about the holding current? The holding current is the minimum anode current to maintain the thyristor. That is, the holding current is the minimum anode current to maintain the thyristor in the off state. That is, this value of the current that brings towards the thyristor to off condition. Below this value, it should be becomes towards the off condition. Okay, next. Suppose thyristor conducts and it behaves like a conducting diode, that is a switch, and there is no control over the device. For suppose, nothing but we discussing about the only two terminals are provided for a circuit device, anode and cathode is to be provided, and a gate is to be removed. For suppose there is no gate signal and there is no gate terminal, what happens here? The device continues to conduct because there is no depletion layer on the junction J2 due to free movements. There is no blocking state of the junction J2 value. Therefore, the junction J2, due to free movement of the carriers, what should be happen? The forward anode current is reduced below a level known as the holding current. This is nothing but the holding current. Here, under this condition, a depletion region develops around junction J2 due to the reduced number of, this is, a depletion region has been developed due to the reduced number of carriers under this condition, junction J2, carriers, and the thyristor is under the blocking state. The holding current is on the, it is on the order of the milliamperes, and is less than the latching current, That is, this the holding current is to be very small value compared towards the latching current. Here shows that latching current should be very high compared to the holding current. That is nothing but the high holding current. Holding current is to be less than the latching current. If the thyristor is under the, these are the forward states, forward bias conditions. If come across the thyristors or the SAR in the reverse bias condition, what happens? That is, when the cathode voltage is positive with respect to the anode, when cathode is actually in previous in the forward biased condition, anode is positive with respect to cathode, but here we changing towards the reverse direction. That is, cathode voltage is positive with respect to the anode, what should happen? The junction J2 is here. This is nothing but the junction J2. The junction J2 is under forward biased condition, and the junction J1 and J3 are under, this J1 and J3 are under reversal biased condition. This is the condition that occurs whenever cathode is made positive with respect to anode. That is nothing but which shows that any two series connected diodes are connected. Any two series connected diodes are applied with reverse voltage across them. Nothing but which shows like that. The thyristor is in the reverse blocking state, and a reverse leakage current. This is nothing but the reverse leakage current. Actually, it is the forward leakage current. This is a small leakage current under forward condition. But if you observe here, this is nothing but the small reverse leakage current. The thyristor is in the reverse blocking state. Under this condition, reverse leakage current, known as the reverse current, I suffix R, flows through the device. When a cathode is made positive with respect to the anode, under this condition, reverse blocking state should be occurs. Under this condition, a small reverse current should be flow with respect to the negative voltage applied. That is, reverse voltage applied here. There is also reverse breakdown here occurring here. That is, under reverse biased condition, up to reverse breakdown voltage applied here, up to the condition of the voltage, it should be very small value. Nothing but the current should be very small. That is the reverse current under reverse blocking regions. Whenever the voltage has been increases more than the value, therefore, what should be happen? A reverse breakdown can be occurs. Therefore, the current value under reverse condition is increases. This is the highest value that which it damages the device completely. There is a reverse current of under reverse blocking region with respect to the voltage value of negative voltage, reverse voltage applied here. What should be happen? The reverse current increases with a high amount of value, which damages the device. The switch. Here, this is nothing but the forward biased and also the reverse biased and also the operations of the thyristors and the VA characteristics we observe here now. That is a forward breakover and reverse breakdown, forward blocking region, reverse blocking region, and forward conducting region. These are all the thyristor VA characteristics, nothing but under the operation, there are the VA characteristics which we shown here. And next, what are the important points we observe here? That is, once a thyristor, if you turned on by giving a gate signal and its anode current is greater than the holding current, and the device continuously conducts due to the positive forward bias applied voltage. Here, even if the gate signal is removed, a thyristor is a latching device, nothing but under on condition only. That is, what I am telling is here, whenever the anode voltage is to be made positive with respect to cathode, here what should be happen? Therefore, under this condition, with applying the gate signal, the device is under turn on condition, like acting act as a switch, as turn on condition. If doesn't required under after the turn on of a switch or a device, the gate signal is doesn't required furtherly, and therefore the gate signal is to be removed. Gate signal is removed whenever the latching current is to be, the holding current is to be less than the latching current of the device is to be happens, then only turn off of the thyristor happens. Then only the turn off of the thyristor happens. Here, the important points is to be of the thyristors we observe here again. A thyristor belongs to a family of four layer devices. That is a latching device. It latches into full conduction in its forward direction when its anode is made positive with respect to the cathode, and only when a voltage or current pulse is applied across the gate terminal, to its gate terminal. Here, the forward anode current of a thyristor must be more than the latching current to latch into the conduction state. Otherwise, the device reverts to the blocking state, nothing but comes towards the blocking state. And the anode to cathode voltage is to be false again. That whenever it coming towards the reverse blocking means the anode to cathode voltage is to be coming towards the negative side, that is false. If the forward anode current of a thyristor is reduced below its holding current, the device becomes unlatched and remains in the blocking state. The device is to be under this region is to be under blocking state only. Once the thyristor conducts, it behaves like a conducting device or a diode switch, and there is no control over the device. That is, the device cannot be turned off by another positive or negative gate pulse. That is nothing but this is the gate terminal is required only to turn on purpose only. What about the turn off? That is, whenever the thyristor voltage is to be reverse voltage is applied, that is cathode is made positive with respect to anode, what should be happen? That it should be comes towards the off state or reverse blocking state. These are the points we discussed here. And next important point is to be, in a forward biased condition, there are two different states in which we examine in the SCR of a forward biased condition, that is the high impedance or the forward blocking state, or the low impedance or forward conducting state. These we discussed previously. That what in the name of the forward blocking we also called as high impedance, low impedance values. Here, at a critical peak forward voltage, the SCR switches from the blocking state to the conduction state. I think in this point we discuss about the junction J2 value. That is, junction J2 is previously on reversible biased condition. J1, J3 is only forward biased condition. At critical peak forward voltage, whenever the voltage value, anode to cathode voltage value has been increased to a sufficient large value, therefore the junction J2 comes towards the forward biased condition. Here, a positive voltage places junction J1, J3 and forward bias, and the center junction J2 reverse bias under this condition. The forward voltage in the blocking state appears across the reverse bias junction J2 as the applied voltage V is increased, that is sufficient large value. The voltage from the anode to cathode is very small after switching to forward conducting state. Now all the three junctions are forward biased. The junction J2 switches from reverse bias to forward bias condition. What about the reverse biased means? That is, and the cathode is made positive. These are the some points, important points. And here, HCR in the under reverse bias condition, how it behaves. If you observe of a four-layer PNPN device, here the junction J1, J2, J3, and here if you observe that the PNP transistor plus NPN transistor has been shown. Actually, this is nothing but the HCR is like a two transistor model. That it can be explained the two transistor analogy also. PNP and also the NPN. If you observe PNP and NPN, NPN we consider here. Here, I current, that is the thyristor current I is to be moving towards the anode. Okay, and here these are the emitter base collector, and here also the emitter base collector has been shown for a transistors, and the base current which is equal to the collector current of the second NPN value, and here collector current IC1 is equals to base of the P of NPN transistor. Here we showing that the combination of the PNP transistor and one NPN transistors of a complete PNPN combination of NSCR. Here, under forward blocking condition of the SCR, when the device is biased in the forward blocking state, suppose the applied voltage appears primarily across the reverse bias of junction J2. Therefore, the junctions J1, J3 are forward biased, and the small leakage current is to be moving, that is the current is to be very small. P1, N1, P2, N2. These are nothing but the here junction J1, J2, and J3. Under this condition, what should may happen? J1, J3 are forward biased condition. That's why the depletion region is to be very less due to the majority carriers of the holes and also majority carriers of the electrons here. What should be happen means there is a free movement of the charge carriers from P to N, but here it should be blocking. Why? Because the junction J2 has becomes reverse biased. Due to this condition, there is a depletion region should be very high. Depletion region, that is nothing but the region of this depletion N and also the P of junction J2 has been increases. Therefore, there is no free movement of charge carriers from junction J1 to J2 and up to J3. This condition happens up to the forward blocking state. This is nothing but the forward blocking state. And here, as IV characteristics shown here, after that, whenever the anode to cathode voltage has been increases up to the avalanche value, when brings towards the avalanche breakdown voltage value, that is a forward blocking voltage value. Therefore, what should be happen under this condition? The device becomes towards the turn on, that is nothing but junction J2 brings towards the reverse biased condition towards the forward biased condition. Therefore, the free movement of charge carriers is possible. Therefore, anode current, the current should be moving is to be very high. Large current should be flow. Initially, there is a small amount of current. This is the current. After that, what should be happen? A large amount of current should be flow, and the device is to be becomes to turn on. What about the forward conducting state? After that only forward blocking only that this becomes towards the forward conducting state without a gate pulse. Here shown that junction J1, J2, and J3 having the depletion regions should be very less. That is, the voltage drops of V1, V2, V3 wells across the three junctions should be very small. Why? Because under this condition, before that, under blocking condition, J2 is having that high depletion region, but it should be reduced. Why? Because J2 becomes towards the forward region, forward biased. Therefore, there is a possibility of a free movement of the carriers. That is nothing but the electrons injected at J3 and collected at J2 supplies electrons for N1. This is nothing but the depletion region reduces. Therefore, the current through the device can be large. Here, this is nothing but the forward conducting state with increased current value, increased large value of a current value. It is called as a forward. This is nothing but a forward region, forward conducting region. What about the reverse blocking state of the SCR? What about how the behavior of the SCR under this condition of a PNP in four layers? That is, the SCR under reverse biased condition, junction J1, J3 are under reverse biased, and J2 is only on the forward biased condition. Here, in the reversed blocking state of the SCR, a small amount of current from anode to cathode, that is, holes will flow from the gate into P2, the base of the NPN transistor, due to the positive gate current. With respect to the heavy depletion region in the junction J1 and J3, there is no large current flowing, that is, a small amount of current will be flow. Therefore, the required gate current for turn on is only a few milliamperes. Therefore, the SCR can be turned on by a very small amount of power into the gate. Here also, under reverse blocking condition also, we apply towards the small amount of gate current when we apply. That is, with respect to on this region, reverse blocking state, the current should be increases here under reverse condition. Therefore, under this condition, the junction J1 and J3 also becomes towards the forward biased condition. Next, again, IZ, IB characteristics of the SCR has been shown here. That is, if the gate current is at 0 milliamperes, the volt current amperes of the SCR, characteristics of the SCR shown here is, if the gate current is to be 0 milliamperes, suppose, if the gate current is to be 0 milliamperes, what should be happen? The critical voltage is to be higher. The SCR requires more voltage to switch to the conducting state. This is only the zero voltage. With increased value, gate current is to be increased. When gate current is to be increased again. That is nothing but, with respect to the gate current increasing here, observe here, this is nothing but the avalanche breakdown or forward blocking breakover voltage here. Under this condition that it should be turned on without a gate. But what should be happen? Whenever IZ voltage gate current is to be applied here, is up to the half of the voltage value applied here only, the SCR is conducting. IZ1 shows here and next IZ2. Therefore, the turn on time period, should be reduces with for a small amount of voltage only, the SCR is turned on with applying the gate voltage, that is IZ2 greater than IZ1 greater than IZ value. Here IZ is a zero actually, IZ2 greater than IZ1. But if you consider, as the value of the gate current increases, the critical voltage becomes lower, that is shown here, critical voltage shown here. So when the SCR switches to the conducting state at a small voltage value, that is a low voltage for up to this volt, this voltage only that SCR is turned on, and for this voltage only the SCR is turned on. This is nothing but the breakover voltage. At the higher gate current, the SCR switches faster than at a lower gate current. This is nothing but the time should be reduces here. That is IZ2 greater than IZ1. Next, for a thyristor turn on, that is by thyristor is turned on by increasing the anode current. It can be accomplished but so many ways, that is different ways, that is thermal turn on. How the thyristor can be turned on, that is a thermal turn on, but using high voltage dv by dt triggering, that is also called as a triggering method, is also called as a triggering method, which we discuss in the next class of thyristor turn on and also the turn off methods of NACR. I hope that all of you understand about the SCR of operation, also the SCR characteristics of observing on the schematic diagram, symbol, and all the values. Thank you.